Hey friends, this is Sampada Kulkarni from the channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am explaining you the concept of circular queue data structure. In this video series, I have covered the different topics. Like the first video was explaining the concept of YCQ, where I have covered the disadvantages of linear queue. They are overcome by the circular queue. In the next video of this video series is nothing but the introduction to circular queue. After introducing the circular queue, the next video explains you the features about circular queue. After learning the features of circular queue, I have moved forward to the working of a circular queue. How circular queue works, that covered into the fourth video of this video series. The next video was about how the circular queue operates with the help of front and rear pointers. These concepts I have explained in the video number 5. The last video was about detailing of insertion operation into the circular queue. After completing the insertion operation, now we are going to cover the next topic of this video series. So dear friends, before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. The next operation which we are going to perform, which we are going to learn in the video series of circular queue data structure, is nothing but the delete operation. So here in this video, I am focusing on the delete operation on a circular queue. Let's start with the delete operation. It is also called as DQ operation. So this operation, this function is used to delete an element from a circular queue. So whatever the elements are available in your circular queue, if you want to delete them, then you have to use the function delete function or a DQ function or DQ operation. In a circular queue, just same as of a linear queue, always whatever the element you want to delete, that element will get deleted from the front end of the queue or from the front position of the queue. That's why in deletion we will take care of a front pointer or front index. Now let's move forward for the steps which are required to perform the deletion operation. So the first step is, we suppose to check whether the queue is empty or not. As I explained previously, if the queue is empty, then you have to just display a message queue is empty and you have to exit from a function, because if the queue is empty, it means that nothing is available to display. So that's why I display just a message queue is empty and exit from a function. But if it is not, then you have to move forward. Now I would like to explain you, how are you going to check whether the queue is empty or not? Yes, you are very correct. So here we will check the front and rear pointer. If we are, they both are pointing to -1, it indicates that your queue is empty, your circular queue is empty. If they are not pointing to -1 position, it indicates that queue is not empty. And we supposed to move forward to the step number 2. So let's see the step number 2. In the step number 2, here we are checking that whether it is holding a single element or not. How could you find out that it is holding, the circular queue is holding single element? Yes, you are correct. Here you have to check the position of front and rear. If it both are pointing to the same position, it indicates that it will be holding a single element. And if queue is holding a single element, after deletion of that single element, your queue is going to become empty. And always empty queue is holding both the front and rear at -1 position. So that's why whenever it will be having a single element, after deletion of that element, you have to keep in mind that you have to return the element which we have deleted, as well as you have to set both the front and rear to -1 position to indicate that the single element was there and now it is deleted, and now currently my queue is empty. If a single element is also not present, that is both front and rear are pointing at the different locations, it means that it is holding more than one element, then we have to move forward for the step number 2. I repeat, in the step number 1 we are checking whether the queue is empty. If it is empty, display empty message and exit from a function. If it is not, in step number 2 we are checking whether the queue is holding a single element or not. If it is yes, delete that element by returning that element from the function, and you have to set both front and rear to minus 1 position. If this is also not the case, then we have to go for an ordinary case in the step number 3. So what is step number 3? In the step number 3, we have to increment a front pointer circularly to the next position. Now, if you are not knowing the concept of circular increment, then please go through my previous video and then resume this video again for the further remaining content of this video. So now let's consider you are knowing the circular increment. So perform circular increment on a front and then we will move forward. Now how this circular increment will help us? In this circular increment, if your front is at the end of the queue, that is maximum size minus 1 position, then after performing deletion operation, you have to move forward the front pointer to the next position, that is at the starting of the queue, that is at the 0th position of the queue. To perform these tasks easily, we'll use the circular increment, which will help us to move that front pointer easily to the 0th position if it is at the end of the queue. Let's consider you have incremented the front pointer circularly, and now the next step is to delete the element. Delete or dequeue the element, that is return the element, whatever you are having now, you are pointing by the front position, delete that element, and you have done with the deletion of a single element with these 4 steps. For the deletion of the next element, again you have to start from the step number 1. Let's check whether queue is empty. If it is not, let's check it is having a single element or not. If it is yes, then you have to delete that element and you have to set both front and rear to minus 1 position. If a single element is not there, more than one elements are there, then go to step number 3. Perform circular increment on front variable and then delete the element. You have to perform these 4 steps repeatedly for the repeated deletion of the element from your circular queue. These 4 steps are helpful to delete a single element at a time. Now let's delete the few elements from a queue, and you have to update a front pointer always. To understand this concept, let's start to delete the elements from a circular queue. Now let's consider this is a circular queue of size 10, where it is holding the position from 0 to 9. Your front is at position 0, your rear is at position 4. So ultimately it is holding the 5 values in this circular queue. Now let's start with the first condition. Let's check whether this queue is empty or not by checking the position of front and rear. No, both front and rear are not pointing at minus 1 position. It means that it is not empty. So let's move forward for step number 2, where in step number 2 you have to check whether it is holding a single value or not by checking both front and rear at the same position. Here you can see that both front and rear are holding different values. It means that it is not holding a single value. Now let's go for the step number 3, and in step number 3 we have to perform the circular increment of a front variable. So let's perform the circular increment of a front variable. Here I am incrementing circularly the front variable, and now let's increment the front to the next position, and let's delete the element which was present at the position 0. Now let's move forward for the next operation. Let's check whether the queue is empty. No, queue is not empty. Again, not a single element is also available as far as the second step is concerned. And the third step, perform the circular increment. Let's increment circularly the front variable, and now let's move forward for the next position and delete the element. So you have deleted the element, and now your front is at position 2 and rear is at position 4. Now let's perform few more delete operation And before that, let's understand the concept here. Data is not actually removed from the queue. Physically, it is available there, but the elements which are available between the front pointer and the rear pointer, that only we have to consider as the valid elements of a queue. That I have already explained over here, this statement. So that's why whatever the outside of the these front and rear range, then that values are not the part of the queue, and hence we use the term deleted or removed from the queue. So now let's delete the rest of the elements by again performing the circular increment. Before that, let's check whether queue is empty. No, queue is not empty. Queue is not holding a single element, and that's why perform a circular increment. After performing circular increment, let's increment the front to the next position. Now how to apply this formula? I think all of you are knowing this, but let's explain it at least once. That is, currently your front is at position 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 modulo 10 is remainder is 3, and now updated value of front is nothing but 3. So it will get incremented to 3. After this, we have deleted the element as far as the step number 4 is concerned. Let's delete one more element. Let's check queue is empty. No, queue is not empty. Queue is not again holding a single value, and that's why let's perform the circular increment. After performing circular increment, 3 plus 1 is 4, 4 modulo 10, remainder is 4, and front is equal to 4. So that's why your front is at position 4, and now you are ready to delete 33. Here you can see that, let's check the first condition whether queue is empty. No, queue is not empty. Let's check the second condition whether front and rear are at the same position. Yes, front and rear are at the same position. It means that queue is holding a single value. Here you can see that rear equal to front, it indicates a single element in a queue, and reinitialize both of them to minus 1. After deleting a single element, reinitialize front and rear to minus 1. And here you can see that both front and rear are initialized at to minus 1 position. It indicates that this number 44 is deleted from the queue. And at the end, here you can see that if front and rear are at minus 1 position, there is nothing is available in your circular queue, and it indicates that your circular queue is empty. So in this way, we can perform the delete operation on a circular queue. The time complexity of DQ or a delete operation is big O1, because there is no any loop is available for the deletion of single element. If the single element you want to delete, then it will not require any loop. So I hope all of you have understood the delete operation. Thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. Here I am providing you a subscription link for my channel Tech Talks. Along with this, I am providing you a shortcut link for the next video of this video series, along with the whole video series in the form of playlist. Thank you. Happy data structuring. Happy learning. Thank you.